students. Today we are going to start our session, first session in quarter four. With you, Dr. Murray. We are going to start lesson three, work and energy, in chapter 11, exploring forces. Do you remember when we came together in quarter three? Push or pull on an object is excellent force, and the length between one place to another, or between one object and another, is called distance. Exerting this force and moving through a distance, that means excellent work is done. So, what the meaning of work? Work is what is necessary for a force to move an object through a distance. Look at this kid. He is pushing the box, and this box is moving through a distance. So, what is done? Work is done. Excellent. So, how to calculate work? In order to calculate work, work equals force times distance. Okay? And we know that the unit of measuring force is Newton. And the unit of measuring distance is meter. So, the units of measuring work are joules or J capital, and this is because who the first one who discovered or formulated the word is called joules, or it has another unit, Newton meter. Newton meter. So how to calculate work? Work equals force times distance. And can you remember the magical triangle? To calculate work, force times distance. To calculate force, work divided distance. Or we can calculate force by another way. Can you remember when we say Newton's second law of motion? It's force equals mass times acceleration. And in order to calculate distance, work divided force. Okay. Facts. Suppose a student uses a rope to lift a bucket filled with books to a train house. That is 5 meters. A kid is playing in a train house and he is lifting up a bucket, and this bucket contains books. So he is exerting force. He moves 5 meters, and the weight of the bucket is 30 meters. So, calculate the work done on the bucket by the student. As we said, in order to calculate work, it was force times distance. And the calculation will be, the force is 30 meters, and the distance is 5 meters. So, 30 meters times 5 meters, the result will be 150. And as we said, the unit of measuring work is joules or J capital. Joules or J capital. Okay? And by this slide, we finished our first session in quarter four. Thank you, my beloved students in grade 6, for watching this session. See you tomorrow. Goodbye.